CNN versus the Trump administration. There is war going around between the First Amendment as CNN and Jim Acosta filed the first lawsuit on Tuesday, November 12th, and the case was given to Judge Timothy J. Kelly. Judge Kelly focused this case on the key issues that both Jim Acosta's First and Fifth Amendment rights were violated during the White House Correspondents' Dinner. Here is a clip of what started this situation.
That's not an invasion.
Honestly, I think you should let me run the country. You run CNN.
All right.
And if you did it well, your ratings would be much better.
Let me ask, if I may ask one other question. Mr. President, if I may ask one other question, are you worried?
That's enough. That's enough.
Mr. President, I was going to ask one of the other folks.
That's enough.
Pardon me, ma'am. Mr. President.
That's enough.
Mr. President, I had one other question, if I may ask, on the Russia investigation. Are you concerned that... that you may have
I'm not concerned about anything with the Russian investigation because it's a hoax.
And this is something that Acosta has been doing for years as a journalist, doing his job. You can see in the video that he was trying to get some answers within the president, even though most of what he and his administration says is a big fat lie. Trump also states many times after his correspondent meetings that the media is, quote, the enemy of the people. And this is something that he has been doing ever since he took office, constantly attacking journalists who are just trying to do their job. And Jim Acosta isn't the only one. Abby Phillips, another White House correspondent, has been verbally harassed by the president. She was asking the question about the Russian probe situation, and here is what Donald Trump had to say to that. Can we play that, please?
Do you want him to rein in Robert Mueller?
What a stupid question that is. What a stupid question. But I watch you a lot. You ask a lot of stupid questions.
These clips I just showed you would be considered in Donald Trump's mind fake news. But here's the problem with his opinions, because that's what they are. They're opinions. The problem is 90% of the time, CNN states facts. The Trump administration tries to dodge these facts. It's not fake news when there is both audio and visual proof of these statements. Let me show you an example of fake news. Here's one of the tweets that Sarah Sanders said after the White House Correspondents' Dinner that started the whole thing with Jim Acosta's press pass being revoked. She says, quote, President Trump believes in the free press and expects and welcomes tough questions of him and his administration. We will, however, never tolerate a reporter placing his hands on a young woman just trying to do her job as a White House intern. All right, so let's just look at this clip again, but slowly. Can we bring up the clip again? Slow. Yeah, thank you. Okay, so Jim Acosta is asking the questions that he's trying to get out of the president to answer. We can see the intern actually trying to force the microphone away from him. In fact, she touches him before he gives the microphone away. That is an example of fake news, hypocrisy at its finest. What also cost them the first case, because that's what this is. This was the first case. They're suing them again for the same reason and violation of the judge's ruling, you know, is that every single media platform out there is supportive to CNN's decision to sue the Trump administration and to fight for the First Amendment. Even Fox News was a part of this. And most of the time they're against CNN. And Judge Kelly knew this. He knew that there are violations of these amendments going left, right, and center. Judge Kelly also added that the White House is required to restore his White House credentials because his press pass was revoked. You know, they banned his press pass. They are required to restore it, but they have no obligation to call on him during questions. I think the key word we're looking for is loophole. Now, CNN is still fighting for this war to restore the First Amendment for all media and for all broadcasters like myself. So in conclusion, the media must keep fighting for the people, because if they don't, then no one else will. I'm Donny Dark, and I'll see you next time.